My name is Elinor, and I'm turning a 1930s oil tanker into a houseboat.
I've always had boats in my life. I've always wanted to live on a boat, and my grandparents always had a boat, my parents had a boat, and I love the sea.
When I was a kid, my parents bought a boat. We'd go out in it every summer for like 6 weeks, travel around the whole of Sweden, and it was the happiest days of my life. I just always thought I'd live on a boat one day, but it was kind of like, it was just like a dream.
My day job, or night job, you might say, is being a DJ, and I'm also an illustrator. So I was probably not the most likely person to buy a boat of that size.
I moved to London when I was 19. Before that, I'd been living in Stockholm. And when you're in Stockholm, you're always close to the water. So you always have the water next to you, and there's loads of boats around, and someone's always got a boat. So you kind of, even though I didn't have a boat myself, there was always boats around. And when I moved to London, that was the one thing that I really missed, like being close to the water. And every time I went down to the Thames, and sort of, I would walk along the river and look at all these boats, and I'd be like, oh God, it's so lovely, I really want to live on a boat one day.
Yay! You got one.
A few years ago, my personal circumstances changed, and from it being like a dream, it kind of became more realistic that maybe I would actually live on a boat one day. I started looking on all these like boat websites, and there was nothing that seemed big enough or good enough, or it was too done up, and I wanted something that was a bit rough that I could do up myself. I went to look at loads of them, and I always thought, it's too small, I can't stand up straight, or it's all down below deck and there's not enough light, and you have to have furniture that are adapted to being on a boat. And I was like, no, there is no boat for me. One day I was like, oh, I'm just gonna have a little look on eBay, and there it was, the Seven Traveller. And it looked pretty rough, but it was big. It would make a lovely houseboat with a little bit of TLC, basically. It was big. It was massive. It was really run down, neglected for years and years, and it stank of like beer, because it used to be a pub, of rotten carpet, and there was just like shit everywhere. I think this might be the one. I was like, okay. Within a week, I bought it. It's so weird when you buy a boat. There are no like contracts that exchanges hands or anything. It's just like, you bought it, now I'm the owner. But you don't have, it's not like when you're buying a house. And there was a padlock on the door that he still had keys for, the previous owner. I went up there about a month after I bought it, after sort of buying some paint and tools and things, but still I had no clue.
I've spent the last 2.5 years getting rid of a hell of a lot of rust, tons of it. I mean, the boat had been very badly neglected, so there was a lot of stuff to do. I started by hammering away at all the rust and getting rid of all the junk.
My plan was to clear the back deck first, because it was in such a state. I mean, it basically been used as a rubbish tip. It was just full of like, you know, rotten clothes, rat poo, bleh. I mean, yeah, horrible. So I brought with me a pressure washer, and I just got all the crap off and cleaned it. And I was like, oh my God, it looks amazing. But at the same time, it revealed the extent of the deterioration. There was like holes in the deck everywhere, and steel had, I mean, it was so rusty and rotted through. And my plan was to go up there, it was in like at the end of March. My plan was to go up there for about 4 or 5 days and then come back to London. I thought, oh, maybe in 4 or 5 days I will have the back deck done. Mm. 2 years later, it's still not done. Right. It was so hard. So I cleaned it, and then I sort of started scraping and thinking, oh yeah, how do I get rid of the rust? And then I realized like the hammer is the best thing. So I just sat there hammering for like days, just getting the rust off. And I ended up spending 8 weeks up there without going back to London. I was so in it, it didn't feel like a job really.